What if I told you there was a way to change between all of your settings, all of your files, all of your libraries instantaneously in ProPresenter? Well, in version 20 there is. So stick around and we'll find out. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what's new in ProPresenter version 20? Part 1. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if there's ever been a situation where you wanted a totally new installation of ProPresenter, but you wanted that for someone that you didn't want them to mess with your normal files, go ahead, tell me about it in the comments below. So here's what's going on. ProPresenter version 20 was just announced, but as I'm recording this, it hasn't been actually announced to the public. I'm part of a beta group, so I knew about it a little early. But there's some cool things that are going on that I don't know if anyone else is going to mention. So let's head over to the computer and we'll take a look. So we're in 20, looks just like 19, but there's a couple of little things that they've done. Now, the second of these isn't available yet. I'm recording this really early just so that I've got it in the can. But the first one is, and it's going to be really helpful to me, and depending on how you use ProPresenter, it might be helpful to you. And I'm going to suggest a way that you should use it just in case. So let's just go over to ProPresenter up here, and then Settings and General. And when we do that, notice there's this little space called Workspace. Now, I want you to think of this as a totally different user. So, as you may know, I've been traveling all over the country. I'm not going to talk about that right now, but when I teach one of these classes, I factory default my ProPresenter. And, well, basically it looks like this. So I'm going to click on this and go to this one. And pop! That's exactly how it looks. So, factory defaulted. Now, when I teach the classes for my Church Tech U members, I use the same set up on ProPresenter that I use for you when we're doing these tutorials. And so I go down here and I use this one. And pop. That's good. So some of you are thinking, well, that's not all that helpful to me. But what if you have a children's ministry or a youth ministry that uses the exact same ProPresenter computer? You could have a different workspace that is the youth version or the children's version that has all their preferences, everything set up. What if you have a ProPresenter computer that's like a laptop or something that you take to different classrooms? Well, you could have a different workspace for each classroom so that all of the displays are set up correctly. So it's just a matter of changing between those. And what I think everyone should do is they should just select Manage Workspaces right here, select their default one, and then click on this right here and select Duplicate. When you duplicate it, instead of calling it default or whatever you're going to call it this. Backup. Once a month, before you leave church, before you shut down ProPresenter, just go in here, create a backup, and I personally like to do the last two of the year, the two of the month, and the two digits of the date. So now I have, once I select create, I'll have a backup of my default ProPresenter. in the state, and I'll know exactly when it was good. So I click create, and if I have any problems, I can just go into this backup at any time, and then I know that I've got that there. Now, ideally, I would want to take this entire folder and back it up online or back it to an external hard drive that's not connected to the computer in case there's a surge or fire or whatever. But that's something else that you can do with it, is just use it as a backup that you can always go back into. So you could do that as well. So that's something that I think is really cool. And just so you know, you can also access it from up here. So go to status and look, drop down for the workspace. So we could go to the backup and notice it looks identical to how it was. So that's pretty helpful as well. So that is one of the new features that they have in version 20, and it's one that I think that everyone should use, bare minimum, to make monthly backups. But also, if you move your ProPresenter computer around from time to time, if... Oh, another one that I might want to show you is I have this one, internal audio. This is identical to my default one, only I have totally different audio routing. And the reason that I did that is because normally I have audio set up for my live stream Q&A that I do for my Church Tech U members. But this is better for when I'm doing stuff and I just need local audio. So I could have that swap over. So that's another cool thing that I can do with it. And that just basically you could have exact duplicates except for one setting and deal with it that way, which is what that is exactly. So that's these different workspaces that are now available in ProPresenter 20. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course, so head on over to TDM.fyi/ProQuick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford with TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.